Today, I will install Windows 10 build 9785 in VirtualBox. This is an early build, much closer to Windows 8.1. I find it interesting because it is basically how Windows 8 should have been designed. Here's the product key, and the link to download the ISO file will be in the description below. Note, this product key only works during setup, and this beta build can't be activated normally. Let's just install it. This is pretty standard Windows setup. Now, why did I choose this exact build? Well, because it fixes almost all features of Windows 8.1 which were either confusing or difficult to use and which weren't generally appreciated. Because unfortunately, Windows 8 and 8.1 failed despite introducing some great features that we still use every day. I want to show you the OOBE, which remains unchanged since Windows 8.1, because you will see something interesting. While Windows 8 had telemetry, it was disabled by default, as you will see in a moment. These three switches here, they are not turned on like in Windows 10, and they are fewer, to be honest. While this build does offer a Microsoft account by default, you can tap on the link to create a new account, and then opt for a local one instead. Well, not in the beta, of course, but Windows 8.1 was like that. Let's finish up here, and it's time for the desktop. There are a few features which are new to this build compared to regular Windows 8.1, and I want to talk about them. The build has some serious bugs, however Windows 8 wouldn't have failed if it had introduced more stable versions of the features I'm going to show you in a moment. Right, here's the desktop. Now let's open WinVir, and then let's get started. The first feature, different from regular Windows 8.1, is the Start menu. Yes, here it is, combining the Windows 7 layout to the left and the Windows 8 tiles to the right. While the feature set in the Start menu generally remains the same, this is perhaps one of the best Start menus I have ever seen, and also it isn't as bulky as the Windows 10 Start menu, which I dislike. Windows 10 did, in fact, offer a full-screen menu, which for me was much better than that bulky default menu. You can right-click and pin items, as you can see. The only issue with this menu is the way it fills unused space, which could have been reworked, but this is a beta build anyway, and I'm not sure Windows 10 is any better. Here's the old Start screen in the taskbar and Start settings. It is great for tablets and Windows 10 had it, but this one is better. Let's sign out for this. The Windows 8 Start menu hasn't been changed in any way. Let's continue. This feature is a must-have if you are designing a desktop OS, Microsoft. Did you forget the PC user with the Windows 8 Metro apps? At least a basic title bar was made available in Windows 8.1. In this build, there is a hidden feature in RegEdit which allows Metro apps to be windowed. It is terribly buggy though, and needs a reboot, but let's try it out. You need to go to HK Local Machine, Software, Microsoft, Windows, Current Version, Immersive Shell. In this key, you should add a D word and name it Modern Desktop Apps. Change its value to 1. Then after a reboot, Modern Apps will launch windowed. I tried restarting Explorer only, but it didn't exactly work. Especially for Calculator, which I tried to open. Honestly, I thought Calculator is one of the simplest Metro apps, yet it doesn't want to work. I guess you'll have to work with the other Calculator app. The Windows 7 one actually shipped with Windows 8 and 8.1 and hasn't been removed yet in this build. Did it ship with Windows 10? I don't remember. As you can see, the modern one tries everything in order to crash quietly in the background. Let's reboot and try again. This time Calculator actually opens, but since the feature is unfinished, it complains about the unsupported screen size, and I can't even maximize it. Here's the title bar, as you can see. After many attempts, and low stability, I was finally able to open two Metro apps, Scan and Video, without problems. As you can see, Explorer is having a hard time staying open and not crashing, but here's Scan. Let's move it a little. It actually managed to open. Let's maximize and yes, it works. But closing the apps also takes a very long time, as you can see, and it's kind of glitchy. Let's try Xbox Video now. It is more complex as an app, and while it opens, it is glitching along the right edge, but is at least kind of usable. As you can see, let's scroll a little. Well, it's usable until it prompts for an update. Maximize and restore also work, surprisingly. Let's try again with the calculator app. Do you think it will work? Come on, just open. It's not that difficult. And yes, it works. But, whoops, it just crashed my entire VM. I've had enough of this feature. The next feature doesn't work on this build. It is hidden inside the notification area icons control panel. Later in the development of Windows 10, this feature becomes a working notification center. 9807 is the first build where it actually opens. Here it's just an icon, and it doesn't do anything. Let's go back into RegEdit for yet another feature that doesn't work, the search icon. Go to HKEY Current User, Software, Microsoft, Windows, Current Version. Right-click and create a new key, Search. In the new key, you should add a DWORD 32-bit and name it Enable Proactive. Change its value to 1. Then restart Explorer and you will see a search icon on your taskbar. Since the start button does have search, I don't really know why they have decided to add this feature. Maybe it is supposed to be a reworked Metro search, which was available in the old start screen and could also show web results. As you can see, the search icon doesn't do anything and you can't even remove it with the right-click menu. Some people have managed to open a blank box, perhaps after a reboot. And just as I opened File Explorer, the new home appeared. It didn't ship with Windows 10, it was replaced by Quick Access, and only in Windows 11 22H2 did something similar arrive. Overall, I have never used anything like this. I like this PC the most. Finally, I will compare the PC settings app on my host machine, which is on Windows 8.1, with this beta build. In fact, there are only a few notable changes, starting with the flights feature, which is definitely a Windows beta thing. It might be related to the insider program in Windows 10 and 11. Perhaps this drop-down allows you to select which build you want to receive next, and the other one schedules the restarts. The rest of Windows Update remains the same. And I also want to show you the battery saver feature, which is also new compared to Windows 8.1, I believe. So that's it, thanks for watching, please subscribe, and why not watch another video on my channel.